first of all, so this is Blaze the Movie Fan, and aside from this video, I have all my summer projects ready, all except one. And unfortunately, I couldn't finish it before the end of July. So it is gonna be delayed until later. But let's hope that I will be able to finish it before September. There's unfortunately still a chance that I will not. Anyway, many people recommended movies about the summer to review as the final spoiler-free movie review of an old movie that I make in July. The requested review doesn't count, since that one is an entirely different category altogether. Anyway, I've never even heard of Joe vs. the Volcano, so let's talk about it. This movie is basically about a very depressed guy who doesn't have much good going on in his life. First, we're gonna talk about Joe Banks, played by Tom Hanks. Wow, Tom Hanks is playing the main character. He is one of my favorite actors of all time, in case you guys didn't know. Anyway, like I said earlier, he's a very fucking depressed guy and never feels any happiness in his life. And I feel sorry for the poor guy because of it, I really do. He deserves happiness, everyone does. And the poor guy is trying to find happiness, but it's not easy for him, unfortunately. The poor guy. Now his boss is Frank Vartory, played by Dan Hedaya. Now, there are a lot of asshole bosses in fiction. I would say that this isn't one of them. Because his reasons for his disapproval of Joe are completely understandable. Joe really isn't doing his fucking job right in this movie. So he's right to call him out. And yeah, Joe's incompetence really is his fault. He might have issues, but that doesn't excuse him not doing his fucking job. In fact, I think he deserves to be fired. Now then, normally there's a third character that I want to talk about, but there is no third character this time. Wanna know why? Because the best characters appear pretty late in the movie. And I don't want to spoil, but let me say this. This movie is full of characters that are fucking awesome. That's what I like about the movie, honestly. Now, something special happens to the main character, Joe, after the half an hour mark. And that's when the movie gets more interesting. I mean, it was interesting before, but then it gets even more fucking interesting. And I will not tell you what that special thing is, but I know why. Because I want you to have the best time possible watching the movie. And the movie is a lot more enjoyable if you don't know that stuff. But I will give you a clue though. The title does give away what most of the movie is about. That's all I will say. But there is one thing that I have to give the movie credit for. It's extremely fucking creative. There's no other movie like this. And that is fucking awesome for sure. And I don't just mean that the movie has a creative concept. Nearly every fucking scene in this movie is unlike anything that I've ever seen before. And that is fucking awesome. Now it's time for my overall thoughts. This is honestly a fucking awesome movie. In fact, I wouldn't mind revisiting it for a spoiler movie review. And for that, I'm of course gonna give it a rating 2 thumbs up. One more thing before I end this video. The final summer project is a skit video called Homer in New York, which is about Homer Simpson going to New York City with his boss, Montgomery Burns, which are good friends in that skit. However, it is taking an incredibly fucking long time for me to finish that skit. I want it to be up as soon as possible. In fact, I hope it will be ready before September begins, but I don't promise anything. Just know that I'm fucking working on it. Thank you all for watching and you all have a fantastic day.